let's talk the real deal here. Priority based scheduling, the criteria here we are assuming is preemptive. That is, we can stop the process if a higher process comes in between, right? This is the question that will be given to us. Question, and let's make the Gantt chart and proceed through our way. The process remains the same. At time 0, process P1 is coming, executed for 1 unit of time. At 1 unit of time, any higher process coming, higher priority process at 1, P2 is coming, but it has lower priority than P1. 3 is less than 2, so execute P1 for another unit of time and reduce burst time to 2. Now at 2 unit of time, any higher process, priority process is coming, P3 is coming, it has higher priority, yes. So execute P3 for 1 unit of time and reduce your burst time to be 4. Now at 3 unit of time, any higher process coming, higher priority process at 3 unit of time, yes. P4 is coming, it has higher priority, so execute P4 and for 1 unit of time and reduce this to 2. Now at 4 unit of time, any higher priority process, yes, the boss is coming, P5. P5 has the highest priority, so execute it for its whole burst time because no other higher priority process will be coming, right, to preempt it. So execute it for 7 unit of time, 4 plus 7, 11. Next, P5 is done. One important thing, higher the number, higher the priority. It will be mentioned in the question and this has highest priority. I forgot to mention it earlier. I'm sorry for that. This is highest priority. Now the next process that will be executing is the next highest priority remaining. Now P4 is not done, right? It has the highest priority. So execute P4 for how much? It is two burst time. It requires more. So execute for 2 unit of time. It becomes 0. It becomes 0. Now P3. It requires 4 unit of time. So execute for 4 unit of time. Becomes 0. Now P2 or P3? P3 because it has higher priority. P1 has higher priority. So execute P1. For how much unit of time? For 2 unit of time. That is 19. Now the last P2 for 6 unit of time. So 6 unit of time, that means it becomes 25. So the completion time of P2 is 25. P1 is 19. Your P3 completion time is 17, your P4 completion time is 13, your P5 completion time is 11. Your TAT becomes 19 minus CT minus 80, right? So 19 minus 0, 19. 25 minus this, 25 minus 1, yes. 17 minus 2, your 15. 13 minus 3, 10. 11 minus 4, 7. Is this correct? Is this correct? Yes, this is correct. If you add them up, it becomes 75. Waiting times comes out to be TAT minus BT. So 19 minus 4. 19 minus 4. Initial wala dekhenge. Right? Don't mistake here. So it comes out to be 15, 18, 10, 7, 0. If you add them up, it becomes 50. So your average TAT comes out to be total TAT divided by the number of process. So the number of process is your 5, total TAT is 75, so it's 15 simply. Yes, it's 15. Average waiting time is total TAT, total waiting time, sorry, divided by number of process. So it is 50 divided by 5, so it comes out to be 10. This is how you proceed it. And is there anything remaining in the process? No. One homework for you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.